I set out on a narrow way many years ago, hoping I would find true love along the broken road. But I got lost a time or two, wiped my brow and kept pushing through. I couldn't see how every sign pointed straight to you. That every long lost dream led me to where you are. Others who broke my heart, they were like northern stars, pointing me on my way into your loving arms. This much I know is true, that God bless the broken road that led me straight to you. Yes, it did. I think about the years I spent just passing through. That God bless the broken road that led me straight to you. couldn't see how every sign pointed straight to you. That every long lost dream led me to where you are. Others who broke my heart, they were like northern stars, pointing me on my way into your loving arms. This much I know is true, that God bless the broken road that led me straight to you. Smile, take my hand. You've been there, you understand. It's all part of a grander plan that is coming true. Every long lost dream led me to where you are. Others who broke my heart, they were like northern stars, pointing me on my way.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered together here in the sight of God and in the presence of these witnesses to join together this man Matthew and this woman Alexandra in holy matrimony. Marriage is an honorable estate. It's instituted of God, blessed by our Lord Jesus Christ, and declared by the Apostle Paul to be honorable among all. It is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently and in the presence of God. Therefore, as we recognize the seriousness of this occasion and the sacredness of this moment, let us ask God's divine blessing upon this service. Shall we pray? Almighty God, our gracious and heavenly Father, we thank you for establishing the family. And we ask now, Lord, that you look in favor upon your servants, Matthew and Alexandra. We pray, Lord, that you be the invisible guest at their wedding. We ask that the vows that they will be made in sincerity and in truth, and be sealed by your precious Holy Spirit. We thank you for this. In the name of our wonderful Savior, Jesus Christ, amen. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I.
Okay. This moment that you have anticipated and look forward to is now about to be realized. The congregation may be seated. As you look through the scripture and look through human history, I'm certain that you'll understand that God's primary tool for teaching us unselfishness, sensitivity, sacrifice, and mature love is the institution of marriage. As you look at your soon-to-be wife, and as you look at your soon-to-be husband, you remember the precious miracle that God has given you in giving you the love that you have for each other. One of the greatest gifts that God has given you is that love. That love comes from God. The scripture says that all love comes from the Lord. And so to sustain that love in the years ahead, we ask for God's help, we ask for God's favor, and for Him to seal this service by His precious Holy Spirit. I want to remind you of some of the things we talked about and that you went over in the material that I gave you in premarital counseling. The things that make a satisfying marriage. Let me just remind you of some of them, and I call this the C's of matrimony. These important words beginning with a C that you need to practice in your marriage. The first we talked about is communication. This is a skill, and you learn it through practice. You're about to go into an education where you will learn how important communication is with each other. The bottom line is you need to talk to each other and you need to listen to each other. And that's my prayer for your new marriage. The next C is consideration. Of course, when we think of consideration, we think of the golden rule that Jesus gave us that teaches us that we show our love by being helpful to each other, being considerate, paying attention to what your spouse says, and showing common courtesy and treating each other with respect. The next C is compromise. We're taught in the Bible in 1 Corinthians chapter 13 that love does not demand its own way. The unloving thing to do would be try to change your mate, but instead you yield your rights and you learn the art of negotiation. If you don't learn the art of negotiation, you've got some difficult days ahead. But you learn to compromise, and you learn to